Goedenavond en welkom, baie dank dat jullie weer eens ingeskakeld het. Hier bij Club Kop, ter ouder gewoonte op een zondag aan 7 uur. Ons praat weer oor die dagboek van Jan van Riebeeck. In laasweekse episode het ons gepraat oor die visserman vryburgers. Jan van Riebeeck het vir hulle een skippietje geleen en hulle is toch te ijverig om tenminste een keer een week smaak het my op te vaar Saldanha toe en daar voels te vang en eiers en train oil daar te kry vir die mense. As ook die Arnhem en die slot van Honingen het hier aangekom met baie drama. En ou van Riebeeck wil toch te graag ontsla raak van hierdie twee skeppies wat baie hoofpyn vir hom gebring. As ook die Maria wat saam met die robbejagd op Angola toe is om daar te loop slawe koop. Voordat ons aangaan vanavond, wil ek eers hallo sê vir die mense in die kletskolom. Ek sê hallo aan Christophe Oukamp, wat deel eerste was in die kletskolom. Dan het jy ingeskakel het Christophe Oukamp. As ook Mike Simpson, goeie naand Mike en Finney Simpson. En Brendan Campbell. En dan twee van die ou staatmakers ook in die kletskolom. Anti-Marxist ZA, as ook RJJ. Ek wil net so effenkies hier opvang. Mense het 'n bietjie corona paniek aan hulle kant, sien ek. Ek hoop allemaal bly corona vry, indien moontlik. Kom, ek stel gaan my kameraatjie op. Hi. Moes het net gauw eers weer hier so. Asie. Pas hy nogal mooi deur vanaand. Maar ek sê ek sy beentjies is evenredig. Ek sê hy werk beter as ek om 'n bietjie laar sit, dan kan jy beter saam lees. Sit gauw om op die boekie. Sy, net gauw jy brille ook skoon maak. Configure video, camera control. Focus, maak hom so 20, kan seker 25 maak, dis so 'n bietjie nader. Daar sê, alles kristalhelder. Ek gaan kyk na die tyd, na my livestreams, en dit smaak my, hierdie nuwe internet van my, doen nogal sy werk. Al die tekst is mooi, duidelik en helder. Ons trek nou by die 1 februari, 1658. Ek moet seker net stel dat die hele ding inpas. The free Saldanha traders returned to the fort in their sloop Pagoon with a fair quantity of eggs and fish. Manne is toch te ijverig om te loop visvang. Dan op die 4de, with the aid of this wind, the robbejagd destined to sail to Angola with the Maria first proceeded to the Robben Island with reeds, spars and 25 lambs for fattening and breeding there. Nou maar die lammers doen uitstekend op Robben Island. Hulle sê toch hier so, the suggestion that another man should be placed on the island we consider as frivolous. Three men were always able to manage before, therefore it should still be possible now. We would prefer suggestions which, instead of increasing the honorable company's burdens, would bring the company relief and benefit. That would be proof that you are faithful and zealous servants. Dit smaak my, Jan van Riebeeck het nou niks meer draad vir Jan Woutersen of enige iemand wat evens weer barstig raak. Sê nee. Spaar vir 'n slag vir ons geld. Moet nie net vraag nie, spaar vir ons geld. Op die 5de, the Maria sailed in the morning with the help of a gentle southeasterly breeze in company with the robbejagd. She is to hug the coast from here to Angola and to explore all ports, bays, inlets, rivers, etc. to see whether slaves and other commodities can be obtained for the benefit of the honorable company. Dan sê hulle ook, Wister Maria, the vessel of the freeman, again left for the islands after they had sold all their fish and eggs to the ships lying here and to the burghers. Nou maar dit smaak my, hulle doen uitstekend met hulle visvangbesigheid en dit, die ouwens is toch te lief. Nou hier is nou by diplomatie, ek gaan sommer deur die hele stukkie vir ons lees. Violent hurricane from the same quarter. In the afternoon, however, the commander again proceeded to the Hout Bay and the Steenbergen to see once more exactly which passes there may be for the Hottentots to get through. For the above-mentioned purpose, he ascended the mountain at daybreak from the Hout Valley, where he had spent the night in the open and examined the whole of the Steenbergen right to their summit, from the Kloof Pass to the furthest point on the False Bay, and found that there were so many passes that it would be quite impossible to confine the Hottentots with less than 10 or 12 radeaus, with extended wings or entrenchments attached to them of 400 or 500 roods to cut off their escape routes. At some places the ground was very stony and would be difficult and costly to cut, and at others somewhat easier, while the services of more than 100 soldiers would be required. But even were the work completed with much expense and labor, everything would still depend on a careful watch being kept, neglect of which at any of the fortified places by somebody or other would allow the Hottentots to escape. In this event, it would never again be possible to induce them to come near us, as they would mistrust us for good and all, with the result that all the great trouble and expense would be wasted. Nou maar ek was hierdie week baie bedrywig. O, hel, ek het nou nie my kaart oop nie. Ek gaan nou vir julle, ek het kaarte geteken hierdie week. Kom, ek maak hom geoop. Dat julle ook kan sien wat waar is. Kom ons kyk wat ene gaan ons vat. Eers die kleiner enetjie. Ja, kom ons vat daardie ene. Dit is een groot kaart, mense. Ek wil hom net gauw so trek, dat julle sal kan saam kyk, voor ek hom oorskakel. Sit gauw eers vir julle aan die kant neer. Nou, sit ek daar die camera af. Daar is hy. Wat ek vir julle gemaakt het, ek het gegaan na Google Earth toe. En ek het gaan screenshots neem in die hele Kaap, prentjies van, en so ingekopie en gepaste diesel. Nou kan ons sien nou al die moderne plekke, hierso is Leeuwkop en The Lion's Rump, Sein Heuvel natuurlijk, hierso lê Tafelberg, daar is Duivelspiek. Nou toe het ek nou, soos wat ek nou die boek gelees het en een bietjie teruggegaan en precies die plekke gekry, toe het ek gaan sien, oké, het ek die so half met die hand ingetrek waar die berge omtrent lê. Hier so lê die fort. Dan Duinhoop was omtrent daar so. Hier lê die Vryburgerse grond. Hier is die groene veld. En daar is die Hollandse tuin. Hier so is die maatskappy se graanvelde. Nou hier loop die, as hulle praat van die Vars of die Amstel River, dis nou eintlik die Liesbeek rivier in moderne tye. Ons gaan vanaand lees van Bosheuvel. Nou die Steenberge waarvan hy praat, lê hier heel onder. Hier so is waar die Steenberge lê. As nou die regte kaart weer aansit, kan nou sien, dit is hier onder. Wat se area is die ooit? Hier staan Capricorn, Muizenberg, Lakeside. Nou wat die eerbare maatskappy wou gedoen het, is, hierdie Tafelberg is redelik afgeslote, en hulle is nou al klaar hierdie ingang. Daar is ons die fort, daar is Duinhoop, daar is Korenhoop. So hulle kan het, hierdie ingang kan hulle verdedig. Maar nou, van hier af, hier lê die Gevelberge, ons wat ons nou deesdae noem die 12 apostels. Nou wil hulle redoos hierso opbou, forte, opsit, om die hele area, want hulle kan nog steeds hier van hierdie kant af inkom en deur hardloop, na daai kant toe, dan wil hulle hierdie hele area, maar Jan van Riebeeck sê, dit gaan verskriklik moeilik wees, hy praat van dis baie klipperig en so aan, en jy kan nou sien, dit is inderdaad baie klipperige grond, die so hier en daar is dalk een bietjie beter, maar dit gaan maar knetter. Maar nou vir toekoms het ek nou een mooi kaart getrek, dus ek weet precies waar alles is. Hier so is The Little Hout Bay en die klein leeuwkop waarvan ons al gehoor het. Kom eens kom terug by die boek. Op die 12de, The Captains of the Arnhem, alweer hierdie Arnhem en Honingen. The captains of the ships Arnhem and Woningen, coming ashore, complained that they had rice and bread for the men for only 2 days in the ships, and they asked for some rice from the land. Here, however, the supply of rice is very limited at the moment. Nou sê hulle onderaan, seeing therefore that God has brought these ships safely to this haven, after a painful voyage, it has been agreed to assist them to the limit of our capacity. In addition to the 30 head of cattle or more than 40 sheep supplied to them up to now, we are with God's help to supply each with a last of rice, and as has been done up to now, in order to conserve the Dutch meat, to continue supplying each vessel with 2 head of cattle and 2 sheep per week. So die Arnhem en die Honingen is nou besig om vir ons arm te maak. All the freemen have on the account been told to make their monthly provisions received last week last as long as possible, because in order to preserve the aforesaid valuable ships and assist them to the extent provided in this resolution, no more provisions are obtainable from the storehouse until relief arrives. The innkeepers have also been instructed not to take in table guests or lodgers, and not to sell bread or other foodstuffs to anyone until further orders and until deliverance arrives. Dit klink omtrent asof hulle in 'n corona lockdown is. Vir die mense wat wil saamlees, daar is, sit nog vir so 'n oomblikie op. The officers of the Arnhem reported that the men of the Woningen had refused to deliver them the 2 casks of pork and instigation, it was said, of the skipper Klaas Spielman, in spite of the fact that there were fully 12 or 13 casks of pork besides as many of meat in that vessel. The Arnhem, on the other hand, had only 3 casks of meat and not half a cask of pork. This is not difficult to believe, as yesterday Spielman in the council objected strongly to the transfer. Hierdie 2 skepers maak my is kwaad vir mekaar, of ten minste Spielman speel nie saam nie. Dit is 'n elle lang story, ek gaan nie alles vir julle deurlees nie, ek gaan net so hier en daar vir julle so die highlights gee. In the meantime, the men of the Arnhem had fetched the last of rice allocated to them from the fort by boat, while the men of the Woningen were sent back empty-handed until the order to transfer the 2 casks of pork shall have been complied with. Hier sit Jan ook nou weer sy voet neer. Niks voordat julle nie maak wat ek sê nie. Ek het vir julle orders gegee. Nou, hier gaan het nou nog oor die Arnhem in die slot van Woningen. Julle moet daar gaan lees vir die wat belangstel. Kom ons sit hom daar neer. Op die 16de februari 1658, skipper Spielman came ashore with the 2 ringleaders, nou dis nou die ouens wat nou kwaad gestook het, accompanied by 2 boatloads of men who refused to allow the prisoners to be taken into the fort. And when the prisoners were summoned to appear before the commander, all the men followed them inside, saying that they would not allow them to be touched. The butler's mate, however, was caught by stratagem and locked up. The men from the ship displayed great hostility and created a great disturbance. So die ouens is baie, baie weerbarstig. Ek weet nie wat met hulle gebeur het toe hulle eendag in Batavia of in die vaderland aangekom het. So bietjie oor die Vryburgers. In the meantime, the vessel of the Freeman returned here with some eggs, fish and half-orm train oil from the Dassen Island, which she had left last Tuesday. Nog een bietjie oor Robben Island to the Commander Riebeek. Is nou wat? Kijk hoe spel. Jan Woutersen, Rietbeek. 450 skape, old and young. Soos wat het vir my lyk. Kijk hy nogal goed na die skape en so aan. En ek het net so vir die interessantheid, hier aan die onderkant, a little lower down it was written, we would like some paper and ink. Hy het ander dag gevra om nog een man te stuur om te kom help. Hy sê, hoor jy so, as jy nog briewe soek, dan moet jy toch maar vir my ook een stukkie papier gee waarop ek kan skryf. Hier kom skepe in, baie skepe, een hele vloot. Dit is die Shellfish op die 18de Februari. She was loaded with 40 laas of rice and 8 laas of beans and kajang. Also some clothing for this settlement and a separate cargo for the slave trade in Guinea and Angola. Hier is nou alweer by die Arnhem en die Honingen. The said ships were therefore ordered to hasten to St. Helena at once to meet the first 6 return ships of this year. Maar Jan van Riebeek wil so gauw as moontlik van hierdie 2 skepe ontsla raak, want dit is net 'n hoofpyn vir hom. Hierso is 'n hele lys of 'n hele stuk wat geskryf is. Die mense wat regtig waar belangstel is meer as welkom om daar te loop saamlees. Ek sal graag hierdie program onder die uur wil hou. En ek is nie lus vir drama in my lewe nie. Hierdie is net drama. Klaas Speelman. Hierdie gaan nog alles oor die Arnhem en die Honingen. The officers of the Arnhem delivered to the commander and council the following resolution passed on board by them, reading as follows. Nou maar die ouwens is nou al klaar nie lekker nie. So die Honingen is die Klaas Speelman skip. En die Honingen is een wat vir die Arnhem boelie. Maar, hoor nou vir die Arnhem. Nou Jan van Riebeek het nou die een skip het ingekom en het nou vir hulle klomp reise goed gegee en gesê, hoor jy so, gaan Sint Helena toe, as die ander skepe verby kom, dan gly julle somme saam met hulle op, terug vaderland toe. En hy sê hulle nou, all were of the opinion that the meat and pork were not nearly sufficient for feeding the men in the ordinary way. Nou hier is nou a brief wat van die skip afkom na Jan van Riebeek toe en hulle is nie gelukkig met die hoeveelheid kos wat hulle gekry het toe. Hy gee hulle nou 'n verskriklike lang verduideliking. En ek het vir julle die belangrikste geonderstreep. Hier sê hulle, we are therefore prepared as it behoves us as humble servants to undertake the voyage in God's name, if only we could, if possible, be provisioned with meat and pork for 5 months. It would in no small way enable us to undertake the voyage if the Honourable Commander Riebeek would order such quantity of meat and pork to be transshipped to us from the slot van Honingen. Nou maar hierdie kaptein, hierdie speelman ou van die slot van Honingen is niks lekker nie. En Jan van Riebeek het nou gesien, wag, hy gaan nou nie. Nou verder met hierdie ou soekie, want hierdie ou smaak my is sommer reg om te begin skiet. Vir die manne wat die story interessant vind, wat van die drama hou, hier sal vir julle iets lekker. Dit sal julle pitkos wees. Maar ek het net die belangrikste geonderstreep, en dit sal wees. Therefore we jointly and individually concluded and decided in our own interest and in the best interest of our lords and masters that we could not leave with such scanty provisions, but should remain here until such time as we were properly provisioned so that we could undertake the voyage in safety. Die ouens sê, ons sal nie gaan voordat ons nie X, Y, Z, hoeveelheid bacon, ek weet nie wat se ander goed. Hulle wil seker nog rum en bier en arak gehad het. Daar is nog een stukje aan die onderkant. En commandeer Riebeek het besluit, the commander and the council of the fort decided that it was not advisable to draw further stores from the slot van Woningen. Ons het net daarover gepraat, hierdie klaar speelman is al klaar moeilik. Hulle gaan nie nog vir hom gunsties vra nie. Daar is nog dramas, drama, drama. The commander and council therefore not only insist on their departure as aforesaid, but hereby expressly order the officers of the ship Arnhem to leave simultaneously with the Woningen tonight. Nou maar toe daar sê Jan van Riebeek, julle gaan nou, ons, ek worry nie hoeveel kos daar op julle skip is, julle gly vanaand. En daar kon ons die boos en daar is die Free Saldanhas, hulle het alweer hulle skipje gelaai, hulle gaan nou daar in eiland toe. Die ouwens geniet dit gate uit. En hier is nog drama oor die Woningen en so aan. The following resolution was adopted on this date. Nou, dit is, ons begin te praat nou oor die Van Harwarden expeditie. Dit is nogal een baie interessante een. Die groot rede hoekom ek hierdie kaarte begin te teken het. It was accordingly decided after repeated deliberations to send another expedition inland the day after tomorrow. Dan het daar so Jan van Harwarden geonderstreep, omdat hy die ouwe is wat hierdie expeditie gaan lei. This has been resolved in spite of the fact that the chief of the Chinohuquas, who had been here before, warned us not to send our men inland again for reasons advanced by him at that time. So, hulle gaan nog steeds. En hulle word ook gesê, to make close inquiries about the names of the tribes. En dan, heel aan die onderkant, op die 27ste, sê hulle, early this morning, our 15 men under command of the sergeant, accompanied by two trustworthy Hottentots, set off on their journey. En maar hulle is daar een klomp koper en tabak en pype en goed gegee en hulle moet nou gaan skaap en besoek by die plaaslike inboorlinge. Terwyl hulle nou weg is, hier kom nog skepe in. Die Achilles het ingekom. She had 92 men on board who, God be praised, were all fit and well. Only two of the crew had died, maar net twee het gesterf. Kan julle nou daai oor vertel? Net twee. Another ship was sighted and shortly afterwards the sergeant of the Wapen van Holland with six soldiers arrived overland from the Saldanha Bay. They were guided by the freeman Jurian Jansen of Amsterdam, who had been in that bay with the sloop Pagoon, and reported that the former vessel had arrived there on 21 February with many sick. Waterrekkers nou, ons kyk nou by die 4de Maart, hulle is al meer as 'n week daarso. She had touched nowhere before reaching the said bay and still had 296 men on board, 9 having died. We had hardly received the news when the Wapen van Holland, which was the ship sighted, reached the anchorage at noon. So die Pagoon is met die Vryburgers met die Pagoon op daar's 'n eiland toe, hulle die skip gewaar, daarby Saldanha Bay, toe hulle somme oor die land, het hulle ouens saamgesteeg, maar dit smaak met die skippe toe omgekom, en die Wapen van Holland is nou in die baai. Hier kom nog skepe. The return ships Oranje and Hector reached the anchorage. Sê hulle hier so, the remaining ships Parel, Malacca and Gekroonde Leeuw also safely reached the anchorage before noon. Daar sê hulle ook hier so, an English vessel also arrived the Bantam. Mike Simpson's manne met Captain Isaac Thiele en merchant Thomas Newman. Ah, sê. Kan Mike Simpson ook een bietjie van sy geschiedenis leer? Ek trek uit jou been. Sorry, Mike. Ek moet ophou. Ek sien die ouwens ook al klaar so met jou score in die kleedskolom. En hier, as jy gesien, ons praat nou hier van die Honorable Cunius. Hy is nou die dikke ding van al hierdie skepe wat nou teruggaan na die vaderland toe. En hy gaan, die Honorable Cunius gaan nogal een tykie hier so aan die Kaap bly. Hier sê hulle op die 8ste Maart 1658. The Freeman's vessel Pagain arrived from the Saldanha and the Dassen Island with a quantity of fish, birds and eggs and brought a letter from our men on the Robben Island reading as follows. The Freeman would like to build a shelter of 6 or 8 poles in which to stay when they are prevented by contrary winds from proceeding on their voyages. Hier kom nog skepe in. Nog 'n Engelse skip, die Thomas. The captain or skipper was Richard Annolf. And the merchant was named Iman Schneider. Hulle sê hierso, the ship had experienced a very painful voyage and was proceeding to the coast of India. Water and refreshments were requested. The ship was allowed to have water, but the request for refreshments was politely refused on the grounds that we required them ourselves. Nou, ons weet nou al klaar, die aardneming in die woningen het ons een bietjie gechoke. Daar het hem gelukkig nou nog skepe aangekom. Ek weet nie hoe die saak eindelijk lyk nie, maar Jan van Diebeek sê hier so, niks kos vir die Engelse nie, net water. Two English ships arrived at the entrance of the bay, but were prevented by the strong wind from reaching the anchorage and had to leave the bay again. Hier kom ons nou by die groot diknek, die Honorable Cunius. Today the Honorable Cunius proceeded inland in company with the commander to carry out a general inspection and to see how the growing grain, etc. was progressing. En hier begin hulle leer nou vir die eerste keer van die Van Harwarden expeditie. Today we learned from a Hottentot that the sergeant who had gone inland in an effort to obtain cattle had encountered no natives as far as the Great Berg River, fully 18 hours walk from here, and had accordingly resolved to proceed further inland for 7 or 8 days to look for them and, if possible, to bring back a large number of cattle. May the Almighty bless this venture. Hier kan julle sien, jammer ek het by die 14e, ek moest dat eindelijk ook gelees het. The Honorable Cunius went out for the purpose mentioned above and at the same time inspected the camp of the Carpens and their cattle. Nou, ek het hier onder, hier by die letters received and sent. Oh jal, moest er gewoon die desktop aan. Ah, kan julle my werkspasie sien? Letters received, volume 2, is dit hy, en ons moet gaan na bladsy 266, is dit korrek? Letters and documents received, ja, 266. Daar leer ons van Bosheuvel. Hier gaat ons nou. As experience has taught you that the land behind the Lion Mountain granted you by the Honorable Van Goens. Nou, ons daar nog zoom in het jylle ook kan sien. Granted you by the Honorable Van Goens. Subject to the approval of the directors is highly required as pasture ground for the company's cattle and should be reserved as such. You may, when you obtain the approval of our aforesaid masters on this head, take instead the Bosheuvel, as it is immaterial to them what land you select instead. So hulle het nou gesê, trek op hierdie ding op. Dan Jan van Riebeek het nou, hulle het gesê, Jan, jy kan maar hierdie stuk rondom seepunt, behind the Lion Mountain, jy kan maar daai stukkie kry, maar hulle sê nou, wacht, die maatskappy wil eerder daar so probeer graan gooi, vat jy die stukkie hier rondom Bosheuvel eerder. Nou Bosheuvel, as hy nou die rechte kaart aansit, kan ons sien, is hier by Wynberg se area rond. So Jan het die stukkie grond geklim, maar hy het nog nie daar begin nie, en hulle sê vir hom, los eerder daai grond, vat my hierdie stukkie grond. So hulle is nou stadig aan besig, hulle het eerst duinhoop gebou en toe sê hulle, oké, wacht, hulle gaan nou hierdie stukkies hier so vir die vryburgers gee, en dan maak hulle in die grote skuur. So hulle is nou besig om uit te brei, hier af met die Vars en die Amstel, en hulle is nou al ander kant die Amstel, en hulle sê, Jan van Riebeek, jy gaan boer nou eerder daar so. In laasweekse episode, toe Harry gekom klaat oor die grond, en hulle het gebespreek oor wie bly waar en so, en toe Jan gesê, wat van jy laat loop al jou vee hier suid van die Bosheuvel, anderkant die Bosheuvel. So Jan het gesê, jy kan jou skape en goed en daai tipe goed daar so wy, en ons vat hierdie stukkie hier so. Ongejaal. En dan, ons leer ook van Dumaan op bladsy 260. Is dit een vanaandse episode of laasweekse episode van Dumaan? In elk geval, kom ons gaan lees oor Dumaan. In die extra boeken, die goed is natuurlijk beskikbaar op watdevolk.co.za. Bladsy 260. Nou hierdie is nou instructies wat van die Here 17 afkom na Jan van Riebeek toe. Hier sê die Here 17, one of the two Hottentots who accompanied Mr. van Goens to Batavia, sodat twee van Harry's stam is saam oor na Batavia toe. One of the Hottentots has died there, and the survivor, having returned with us, his arrival has caused great joy among his comrades. He is already so accustomed to our intercourse that he is in no wise inclined to rejoin his horde, so that he is kept at the residency here and may be employed as interpreter, and thus be able doubtly to earn his food and clothes. He has wonderfully far advanced in the Christian prayers and is very much inclined to them, so that he should be more and more exercised in them. We trust that through him many persons, natives, will be made inclined to be of service to our colonists, as is already the case with some from whom good services are obtained. Nou ek weet nie of ek hierdie story reg lees nie, maar dit smaak my, hierdie is die instructie en links is Jan se antwoord. En hier sal staan, this native called the interpreter Dumaan is a hypocrite and has been more injurious to the company than Harry has ever been. He will not live with us, but in the Hottentoo huts, and wear skins rather than Dutch clothes. Much less will he permit himself to be taught the prayers, etc. So ek ben die ouwe somme, jylle is heeltemaal verkeerd oor die ouwe. Wat was nou eindelijk die waarheid? En dan is daar nog een stuk oor die man, letters dispatched. Letters dispatched, ons wil by bladsy 26 wees. Mense, hierdie boeken is interessant. Hierdie extra boeken. Bladsy 26, waar praat hulle van Dumaan? Hier praat hulle juist van, the Honorable Cuneus on his arrival will give you further information. Harry, as well as the Hottentoo Dumaan, now called Anthony, who had been to Batavia with the Honorable van Goens and returned hither, under the care of the Honorable Cuneus. Nou, die Honorable Cuneus het ons nou hier gekom stop in die Kaap. often proposes to us to seize in conjunction with them and the Kapan the cattle of the Charinghurinas or Charinghuriquas, the arch rogues and the principal tribe of the Black Captain, who in 1656 surprised the Robiach's boat in Saldanha Bay and intended to kill the men after they had taken from it all the copper and tobacco it contained. Also, the Chorachoquas, who last year had stolen the freemen's tobacco from the barrels and as a rule cause our people no end of trouble, but tribes are very rich in cattle but refuse to sell any to the company except the lean, old or sickly. Nou hier is nog baie informatie. Ek julle kan self daar gaan deurlees. Ek gaan eintlik vir julle 'n dingetjie sit in die kletskolom. Kom sit maar die hele ding in. As julle na daardie skakel toe gaan, dan klik julle op die menu en dan by e-books sal julle al hierdie boeke daar kry. Hierdie was Letters Dispatch, so hierdie is Jan van Riebeeck se woorde. En hierdie insig wat ons hier kry, dat die man gesê het, ja maar, ons het al gehoor van Harry af, dat Harry wil graag hê. Ons moet die ander stamme aanvalle so aan, maar dit kom nou van Dumaan se kant af ook. Hy wil dit ook hê. Hy dink dis 'n great idee om die ander stamme aan te val en hulle goedjies oor te vat. Waar trek ons nou? By Maart. Kom ons sluit vir Maart af. Voordat ek 'n smoke break vat. Robben Island, hulle sit 'n klomp hase op Robben Island. The boat of the yacht Shellfish was sent to the Robben Island to fetch some sheep. Nou hieronder kan julle lees, hulle moet probeer hase daar teel. Dan 17de, 18de, 19de, praat hulle weer die van die Honorable Cornelius. Op die 19de, the wapen van Holland left before dawn. Hulle sê ook, the Honorable Cornelius also set sail with the ships Parel, Oranje, Malakke, Hector en gekroonde leeuw. Nou hierdie Honorable Cornelius is 'n groot dik ding en julle kan self sien hierso die in die letters sent and received. Daar word almal mekaar van die Honorable Cornelius gepraat. Dis nogal 'n groot besoek gewees. En soos julle kan sien, daar is 'n klomp skeppe wat onder sy bevel is. Waar trek ons nou? Ons trek nog steeds by die 19de. The boat of the Shellfish returned from the Robben Island today with 20 sheep. The sheep were divided amongst the vessels. Ooh. Kan julle sien wat hier gebeur het? Hierdie Honorable Cornelius. Hy neuk nie rond. Hy weet wat belangrik vir die maatskappy. Hulle het nou nie, jy weet, genoeg vleis gehad wat ek kan. Hy sê, bogger dit. Ons span nou die seile. Ons gaan nou gly. En in die tussentyd, hier kom die Shellfish terug met die 20 skaap wat georder is. Toe moes hulle hierdie Honorable Cornelius se skepe loop agterna sit het om die skaap te loop aflaai vir hulle, want hulle was nog naby genoeg gewees. Pursued the fleet a good distance out to sea. As hulle hierso, Pagain arrived here from the Dassen Island with some birds, fish and eggs as well as a half orm train oil. Nou hierdie het my hart gebreek. Jan Woutersen was so, jy weet, 'n groot persoonlikheid gewees in hierdie boek tot dusver toe. Dis amper asof ek die ou ken, jy weet. Maar hoor nou hierso. Hou maar julle tissuekies reg as julle dalk wil huil. With the passage of time, it is becoming increasingly evident that Jan Woutersen, who was deprived last year of his rank of assistant on the grounds of disgraceful conduct, but was graciously allowed to retain the rank of soldier and in order to enable him to make a living, was placed in charge of the company's sheep on the Robben Island in the hope that he would rehabilitate himself, is behaving as badly as before and is paying no attention to the sheep. According to the testimony of persons who have repeatedly and as recently as yesterday visited the island. Nou maar hy was eers in beheer gewees van die robslanery, die pelsjagtery op Dassen Island en Saldanha. En daar was hy eintlik redes gegee in die boek, Maar hy is ewe skielik teruggeroep. Nee, maar jy gedraai jouself nie. Hulle sê nie eens hoekom nie, net van jy gedra nie jouself nie. In hierdie geval weer, die skaapteelery doen uitstekend. Maar hulle het nou 'n ander rede gekry. Hierso gee hulle so 'n halve rede. Ek weet nie of dit regtig waar die moeite werd is nie. Maar hoor hierso. Moreover, he is guilty of drunkenness whenever he is able to obtain liquor, either from the rations or by purchase, and completely disregards the repeated instructions concerning various matters issued to him, especially the making of beacon fires at the spots indicated for the purpose of guiding the company's ships when entering the bay at night. This was complained by the Honorable Cunius and others, who told us that they had been off the island at night and had wished to enter the harbor, but had only seen flash signals for a moment and nothing more. Dis nou natuurlik as jy buskruit laat afgaan. Hulle sê toe hieronder, blikvuur, a signal made by burning gunpowder. Furthermore, it is reported that Jan Woutersen also does not wish the men under his authority to attend more diligently to their duties than he, which may result in ships being wrecked. This nearly happened with the Paul with the Honorable Cunius on board, whereby the company would have suffered a severe loss. It is also seen that the increase of the sheep is being seriously neglected, and that in various places sheep have been found dead or starving. For these, onthou hierdie found dead or starving, ons gaan nou weer daarvan lees. For these and other important reasons, it has been decided to remove him from the island by the first boat proceeding thither, and to transfer authority to Ryk Overhagen, cadet, who has given proof of his devotion and duty to and good conduct. It has also been decided to send the fiscal along with orders to demand from Jan Woutersen on this authority all our instructions sent there. These are to be handed over and read out distinctly to the above mentioned Ryk. From the fiscal is to admonish suitably to carry them out, and he is in particular to impress on Ryk the necessity of attending the beacon fires, apart from the sheep and rabbits, as well as any other duties which may after a thorough inspection be found necessary in the interest of the honorable company. Waar's my tissue? Thereupon Jan Woutersen with his wife and child is to be brought over to the yacht Shellfish, in which he is to sail for India via Mauritius as a soldier. Daar's Jan Woutersen, ons gaan nou nooit weer van hom hoor in die boeke. Thus done on the above date. Is amper as wel 'n man oorlede is in jou familie. Signed Jan van Riebeeck en Roelof de Man. Abram Gabema. Bliksems. Arme Jan Woutersen. Ek voel eintlik half seer vir die man. In elk geval, hier is die Van Harwarden expeditie nou. Ek gaan nou een smoke break vat, want ons gaan nou alles hoor van Harwarden wat nou teruggekom het en ons gaan nou al hulle avonture. Lees van al hulle avonture. Kom ons het net gauw hier so op die klipkop side. Kan ek gauw een eentje luid? Oef. Gauw een swinkie van my water. Ek verweet ek allemaal gemis. Ek het dan vir RJJ gevang en dan Johan van B is ook hier so. Goeienaand Johan van B. As ook Christo D. Goeienaand Christo D. En Ys Swart. God, ek wil my sigaret light, anders dan kry jy se klaar vanaand toe. Dit is nou al klaar 44 minute in. Ek het nog eers by die story uitgekom he. Was het nou so lang gewees? Ek het te lang gedraai met 'n ander story van, maar ek moes dit bylees dat hierdie domaan, weet jy, hulle die maatskappy aangehits om die ander stamme te loop aanval en hulle vee af te vat. Weet al daardie goed waarvan ons beskuldig word. Dit smaak want dit was juist die plaaslike inboerlinge wat dit wou gehaat het wanneer ons aan mekaar gesê het nee, nee, nee. Dit is sulke tipe goed wat hierdie links is aan mekaar verbylees, asof hulle nie kan raak lees nie. A whole lot of rose air. Shoo. Baie, baie stil in die kleedskolom. Ek gaan hom net so halfpad rok. Ek wil nie julle tyd mors nie. Ek kan miskien in plaas van dat julle vir my kyk, kan ek dalk weer een van hierdie goed. Kom maar gelees 'n bietjie verder hierso. Dit is vir my 'n baie interessante stuk gewees. Jal. Is my goed die makkar vanaand. Daarso. Ek het self nog nie ordentlik die deur gelees. Ek was te besig met ander goed gewees. Hier praat hulle nog van die Honorable Cunius. We have had a long conversation with the Honorable Cunius regarding the cavalry. And he will be able to inform you verbally of everything that you may be able to send us such instructions. En hierdie brief het hulle nou saam weggestuur met die Ulysses en die Spreeu. Of kom die Ulysses en die Spreeu nog? Ja, hier kom nog die slaweskip ook. Brendan Campbell sê, ek het geloof 'n meisievriend wat vir my wag. Nee, wat? Nee, wat? Net ek en die kat. Die kat is my poesie. Het hy dan nou gevlieg, jong? Kom ek nip gauw hierdie ou. Ons kom nou by die Van Harwarden expeditie. Tyd het nou te vinnig gevlieg. Trek gauw vir hom weer daar so. Sit ek side camera. Op 21ste Maart. At night our men returned from the interior having found the pass over the mountain range of Africa against which the Berg River lies and through a kloof of which it flows from the interior. Dan sê hulle onder the nieuwe kloof near the present village of Tulbagh. Ek gaan nou vir julle wys hierso. Ek gaan nou weer rondspring hier na die kaarte en goed toe. So ek het nou nog 'n kaart opgetrek. Jy sien hierdie kaart gaan nie alles vir julle wys nie. Dat ek daardie area ook vir julle kan inkry. En is ook van hulle gee rigtings hierson hoeveel tree hulle gegee het. Man, toch te interessant. Nou maar, hier is die fort mos nou natuurlik. Daar is die Perelberg en die Saalberg lê net daarso. Nou die Bergrivier loop hierso op, dan hierbo. Hulle praat, hierdie is die kloof waarvan hulle praat. Die Tulbagh kloof. Ek het dieselfde hier gedoen. Met die, waar so is die... Daar is ons die kaart. Sien dat ek hier met my hand gekom sin inteken. Daar is die berge by Riebeek Wes. Hier is ons die Saalberg. Daar is die berg by Parel. Hier is die Tygerberg. So alles is mooi vir julle ingeteken. Op skaal, precies. Ek het hier met 'n passer gesit en rooi lyne gesit en trek om hulle paadjie te volg presies hoe hulle deur gestap het. Maar hulle is hierdeur tussen deur hierdie hulle het onder hierdie berg gekom slaap. Ek sit hierdie af. Hulle het hier in Belville, daai area, Paddle Belville se area, hulle daar loop kiep vir die aand. Toe stort hulle hierdeur 2 of 3 dae hulle getrek tot by die bergrivier. Stap hulle so op met die bergrivier tussen die bergrivier en die berge en toe spring hulle hier oor binne in die Tulbagh-vallei in. Trek over die ookie weer daarso. Hulle sê hierso, they came across 2 or 3 small native kraals as well as the black captain, all belonging to the Charigurikwas. The real Saldanhas were so far inland that it would take more than a month's travelling to reach them. 2 members of the expedition had died along the way as a result of illness and the discomforts endured while the chief mason was severely bitten in the right arm by a lion the night before last. Hulle praat hier van wilde pere wat hulle gesien het. This expedition was therefore not very successful while it cost 2 men their lives and a 3rd his health. Nou daar is nou die opsomming, ek het vir julle so 'n half idee gegee hoe hulle deurgestap het. Hier praat hulle nou van Dumaan. The Hottentot Dumaan, who had been named Anthony at his own request and who had been to Batavia and returned with the Honorable Cuneus, has offered himself for such an expedition. Ek gaan net vir julle so die highlights gee. Hier kan julle sien op die 26ste Februarie, toe hulle begin stap, hulle gesê hulle gaan direk oos. Wat ek baie interessant gevind het, hierdie kaarte het niks sin gemaak nie. Maar as jy hierdie kaart vat, kom ek vat gou. As jy hierdie kaart vat, kom ek maak dit gou 'n nuwe een hierso oop. File new, maak so daai selfe grootte. En ons new from visible, waar is hy nou? Sê is daar copy. Dan paste dit om hierso in. Alright, nou kan ek op hierdie kaart werk. Nou kan julle sien, Noord is hierso en ek het hom mooi met die satellietfoto's en wat ook al. Alles pas perfect en hierdie goed het glad nie sin gemaak vir een of ander rede nie. Maar, toe ek gegaan het, en ek sê, ja maar, wat van as hulle nie Noord gebruik het nie? Wat van as hulle magnetiese Noord gebruik het? Nou, magnetiese Noord is lê rondom daar by in Kanada. So dit beteken as ons nou op hulle kompas na Kanada toe moet wys vir Noord, dan gaan hierdie kaart omtrent so moet draai. Daai kant toe. En toe ek daai gedoen het, ewe skielik daar maak alles nou sin. Kom ek skryf net gou hierdie oukie. Ek kan miskien hier my pen uittrek. Nou wat hulle eers gedoen het is, kom ek kies gou 'n mooi rooi hierso. Wat hulle eerste gedoen het, was hulle het van die fort af, het hulle oos gegaan. O, ja. Het hulle oos gegaan, en hulle het hier, net aan die kant die Tygerberg, het hulle gaan kiep. Nou, ek gaan nou net so vinnig vir hulle deurlees, ek dink is 2 of 3 dae wat hulle hier getrek het, dag 1, dag 2, en dan by dag 3 is hulle daar deur, en ek klink bykie by die rivier op. Sien, hulle het eers oos gestap en toe noord-noord-oos en toe noord-oos by oos. Ek het hom mooi uitgewerk en precies die ding uitgeplot. Nou gee hulle die hoeveelheid tree en so aan. Dit smaak my toe hulle hierdie die bergachtige gedeeltes bereik het. Toe raak hulle tree ewe skielik korter. Dit smaak my die ouens het moe geraak. Toe moes ek die goed 'n bietjie shrink, maar dit het alles toe eventually sin gemaak. Maar vir die mense wat daar wil saamlees, hulle praat hier onder ook van van Dumaan, haak in hulle sien towards the present Paddo and Belville is nou waar hulle die eerste aand oorgeslaap het. Hier gee hulle ek het maar net hier gaan onderstreep, hulle is nog op pad na die bergrivier toe. A rhinoceros with 2 horns on its nose carrying them just as goats do. Ek weet nie hoe 'n rhinoceros se horings sit maar so in een bokse hoorings het maar so. So ek weet nie wat lekker hulle hier bedoel het. Hulle gee toch die Hollands hier onder. Want hulle seker gedink die mense gaan vra, wat beteken dit nou eindelijk? En dis maak my, hulle weet ook nie. Die mense wat die boek. En hier op die 1 maart, leaving the Diamond and Pearl Mountain on our right and the Saddle Mountain to our left, we reached the Great Berg River, along which we camped at evening after we had followed it for an hour. Sien, daar het hulle nou die bergrivier bereik, sien hulle het een bykie rondgespring, tussen die plateaurand en die bergrivier, bykie geëxplore daar en so aan. En waar is die stuk waar hulle opgegaan het? Ons trek nou by die, waar is ons nou by die 5 maart? When they reached the mountain, they proceeded in a south-southeasterly direction. So hulle het nou, oh, beweeg ek nou hierdie, oh, as hy. So hulle het nou, hier is so opgestap 2-3 dae, so hier rond, op en af of wat ook al, en toe hulle nou hier so uitkom, so hulle gaan hulle in a south-southeasterly direction, op by die kloof, en hier kom hulle by Tulbagh uit. And after marching on that course up the mountain for about 4 hours since leaving the sergeant, they stopped for the night. There they saw 7 wild horses, a dapple grey in colour, very fat and beautiful in appearance. They are very shy of human beings and evidently so wild they cannot easily be caught. Nou ek wonder of hierdie plaaslike perde was, of ons net mis nou, hier was al klare klomp skepe verby die Kaap gewees, in die vorige, sê maar die hele eeuw. Ek wonder of hierdie perde, jy weet, so'n inheems is, en of nou perde was wat verlore geraak het. Op die 6 maart, they found a large river coming forth from the mountain, which was cut in two by that river which flowed as in between two walls and joined the Berg River, natuurlijk the small Berg River, die klein bergrivier. Proceeding further, they reached another steep mountain which seemed insurmountable. They therefore ascended a hill from where they could overlook a plain estimated to be about 4 days' journey in extent. They saw no Hottentots or Hottentot camps, however. This discouraged them the more so that the Hottentots, who had climbed another hill, returned and stated that the expedition might as well turn back as there were no soldaners thereabouts. Nou, hulle gee hier nie onderkant, gee dit 'n bietjie context, die heuwel wat hulle, heuwels wat hulle geklim het, moes hier rond gewees het, in hierdie area. As ek spring na die ander kaart toe, die heuwels moes omtrent hier rond gewees het. Want hieronder kry ons vir die Woestervallei in Rossenwil, daardeur. Op die 7 maart, the Hottentots, seeing that the sergeant preparing to return home with the cattle and baggage, told him they had seen smoke rising and still had hope of finding natives. Nou maar, hulle het net vir hom gesê, ja maar hier is niks nie. So sê die ou, ja maar ons draai hem sommer nou om. Nou hier waarschijnlijk, wow, wat gaan hulle nou kry, As they seemed dissatisfied with the sergeant, the sergeant suggested to them that they should look for the soldanas themselves, which they were willing to do. Thereupon they were supplied with 3 days' provisions, tobacco, etc., and some additional tobacco to be presented to the chiefs of the tribes that they might come across. Op die 8e, the Hottentots mentioned above returned without having found or seen anybody or anything. It was therefore resolved to break camp at daybreak tomorrow and to start for home. Nou hieronder ewe skielik, hier kom hulle nou uit. On inquiring from our Hottentots what camp or tribe it was, they said that it was the camp of the Sunquas, natuurlijk die Boesmans. They went in that direction after travelling for half an hour southwest by south. We found them to be the Hottentots known as the Charingurinas, who had been visited before by the fiscal. The camp consisted of only 5 huts, but they told us that their great chief lived on the other side of the mountains with the majority of his huts and livestock, and they offered to send messengers to inform the chief of our arrival. This offer was accepted, and the messenger soon left, assuring us that he would see to it that many cattle were brought to us if we would wait until his return. This we promised to do, and we gave him some tobacco, whereupon he left at once. In the meantime, we had obtained 3 cows and 2 calves from the camp, and also did our best to gain their favor by means of tobacco, etc. Dan op die 11e kan julle sien daar soos die mense al klaar siek en so aan. After sunset, the ox carrying Gerrit Bekeren also arrived there. Op die 12e, a little afternoon, the Hottentots of the Charingurina tribe visited us and told us that their chief was coming with some cattle which he wished to sell to us. The sergeant in the meantime visited another camp of 11 huts half a mile away in the east-northeast direction, and returned shortly afterwards with the report that it was a camp of the Sonquas who had nothing to sell. Nou hulle het nog 'n bietjie rondgeneek en so aan die vee en goed kom in, maar net so bietjie hier, bietjie daar, nooit regtig waar baie nie. At about 3 o'clock in the afternoon, Gerrit Bekeren died in the Lord from the illness mentioned. Wat beteken dit when as iemand died in the Lord? The deceased was buried at midday. So hierdie ander ou se gebeendere lê daar ergens in die Tulbag area. Is dit gebegrawe? En daar sê hulle, okay, wag, hulle gaan nou wag vir nog 2-3 dae om te wag vir hierdie groot chief wat gaan kom met al sy skape en beeste. En hier kom hy nou eventually terug. 13 sheep and 1 head of cattle. So nee man, dit is nou nie genoeg nie. Ons het nou eintlik gehoop vir meer. Ons gaan nou ons goed oppak en loop. En hulle sê toe sommer daarso, it was useless to wait as nothing more could be obtained here. En hulle is nou op pad terug en hulle sê, came under the Pearl and Diamond Mountain where we spent the night. Nou hier kom nog 'n aardige storie nou. Okay, wag, dis nou eers die leeu. Dis hom te erg. We reached the small river where we had camped on the night of the 26th. A large lion sprang upon one of our men as they were sitting in a circle round a small fire while the sergeant was distributing the last of the provisions. Pinned him down and bit him in the arm, seriously wounding him. The sergeant saw the beast and at first thought it was one of the calves. But when he realized it was a lion, he seized a firelock and placing the muzzle against the forehead of the animal, shot it. Dis maar want die ou is heel vermink geweest. Ons gaan later daarvan. This morning 4 men were left behind with a cow which was unable to follow. They were to try and bring it home if possible, but it died. Nou op die 20ste, hier kom hy. We left the small river mentioned, and as another person was seriously ill, hulle ging nie sy ou se naam nie, and could go no further, 2 men were left behind with him to follow by easy stages. After travelling for an hour, however, we heard a shot, and 2 men with an ox were sent back to bring the sick man home. But before the animal could reach him, the sick man had died, and he was buried. Nou ek dink ons moet so half tussen deur die lyne hier so lees. Hulle het 'n skoot gehoor. In watter rigting het hierdie skoot afgegaan? En ewe skielik hier is hierdie ou sommer nou ook dood. We brought back only 11 head of cattle, old and young, and 45 sheep. Ek kan nie glo is al 8 uur nie. Die tyd het nou so gevlieg. Ek wil hom daar hou. My ander helfte klaar ook. Sê ek is deesdae lig op petrol. Ek kyk na my gesondheid. Halwe sigarette op 'n slag. Eyswart dink dat die wilde perde zebras kan wees. Ek dink Eyswart mag dalk reg wees. Ek kan nie glo die tyd het so gevlieg nie. Ek is nou eens by maart, ek het april het ek ook. En die eerste slawe kom nou hier so aan. Ek gaan deur druk. Ek hoop maar julle het genoeg tyd van my dat julle ook wil deur druk. O, ja. Wat gelukkig is dit is merendeel skepe wat nou aankom. So ons gaan oor baie spring. Dis net wat baie belangrik is is die slawe wat nou gaan aankom. Ja, ons gaan meeste gaan ons net lees hierdie skip soveel is dood. Trek maar die filter collapse. Oké. Okay. Ek wil hom daar so hê. Nou moet trek nou by die okay, so die van Harwarden ekspedisie het nou teruggekom. Daar's twee ouens oorlede. En ons trek nou by die 22ste Maart 1658. En ons spring sommer oor na die 25ste toe waar hulle sê dat the officers of the yacht Shellfish were given their dispatch to proceed on their voyage to Mauritius. To destroy the company's fort there and to take on board all the men and equipment and convey them to Batavia or Ceylon. Nou, natuurlijk, Jan Woutersen is nou saam met hierdie shellfish gestuur en dit smaak met die compagnie pak nou heeltemal op Mauritius. Hulle het daar geprobeer en hulle kon net die story aan die gang daar kry nie. Toe sê die Here 7 Noorie sê ons gee op, ons het nou die Kaap doen baie beter as Mauritius. Kaap is die ding. Our sloop Skapenjacht was sent to the Robben Island with the fiscal, who was to carry out a full inspection there and at the same time dismiss Jan Woutersen and transfer authority on the island and responsibility to superintendents of the sheep of Ryk Overhagen. Jammer man, my Engels is baie keer nie so lekker nie. Op die 26ste, hier kom nog skepe in, die wapen van Amsterdam, with 317 men, of whom 2 had been drowned, and 9 had died of disease. Gelukkig zijn hierdie keer only 9. Many of the men were suffering from various diseases, and scurvy. En hier kom die eerste skapen, slaven nou in. Nou, hierdie wapen van Amsterdam. Nee, ek lieg. Hulle het nuus gebring. On the 19th of December, she had sighted the Amersfoort for the first time. Nou, hierdie Amersfoort captured a Portuguese slave, so hulle het een skip gaan oorneem van die Portugese, wat gaan slawe koop het. The Amersfoort had taken off 250 slaves and left the rest in the Portuguese ship, which was old and unserviceable, from some were falling ill and dying owing to the long duration of the voyage. Oh, hier kom nou nog een skipje in. Die Spreeuw met 154 mans aan boord, of whom 15 had been taken off by the English at Plymouth. En hulle sê ook 10 had died on the voyage. En hier kom die Amersfoort. En hulle sê, a day after the wapen from Holland, and the wapen from Holland with 323 men on board, of whom 29 had died, and approximately 30 were prostrate with scurvy, for whom suitable refreshments were as usual daily sent on board. The weakest were brought ashore to be refreshed, and also the slaves who had been taken off the Portuguese ship on the coast of Brazil in 12 degrees south latitude and had been reduced by death to 170. So dis maak my 80 van hulle is oorlede. Ons het net nou gelees dat in die ander boek, in die letters dispatched, hulle het 40 teruggestuur Batavia toe. Of whom many were ill, so die slawe is nog siek ook. The majority of the slaves are young boys and girls who will be of little use for the next 4 or 5 years. They were also brought ashore to be refreshed and restored to health. Nou hieronder sê hulle, this was the first important importation of slaves at the Cape. Previously only a few slaves had been brought in individually. The Skapenjacht returned from the Robben Island with 20 sheep. Nou sê hulle as 399 skape oor. Ooh, daar prys hulle nou vir ryk overhagen. En hier kom nou nog skepe in. Die Ulysses, with 44 men on board, none of whom have died. En dan kom die Hof van Zeeland ook in. 150 men on board, of whom 2 had died, the rest being fit and well. En die spring is nou oor na April toe. En dit gaan nou merendeels oor die skepe. The ships Princess Royal and Enkelhuizen safely reached the anchorage. They had so veel men on board and no sick while only so veel had died. Hulle sê net aan die onderkant, ja, maar dit staan nie in die, dit is omitted, dit is uitgelaat. The following resolution was adopted today, partly from the Honourable Commander Cornelius Kwaalbergen. As you so, Cornelius van Kwaalbergen was later to become the third commander at the Cape. Dis maak my Cornelius van Kwaalbergen. Kom stop nou vir, ek weet nie die hoeveelste keer, maar hy gaan later aan commandeer raak van die Kaap. En net vir die mense wat graag wil saamlees, gaan ek hierdie goeikies bysit. En hierso is nog 'n grant of forest lands to Pieter Paulson. Nou maar ek het al hier probeer. Ek kan not 'n sokkie uitmaak wat hier geskryf staan. As 'n ander ou vir my sê dit en dit en dit staan hier, ek sal hom maar net moet glo. Ek kan nie hierdie handskrif uitmaak nie. Maar is nogal fantasties dat hulle hierdie dokumente opgespoor het. Dink julle nie ook so nie? Ons trek nou by die 5de, 6de April. The following persons were today betrothed before the council in accordance with the resolution appearing hereunder. Hendrik Hendriksen of Surwerde, a local bachelor and freeman, 23 years of age, who had given a promise of marriage to the virtuous young woman Griekie Fransen Meerkhof, born at Steenwijk, 19 years of age, who is in the service and under the guardianship of the senior merchant Willem Reinersen of the Wapen van Amsterdam, lying here at anchor. So dit maak my Hendrik Hendriksen gryp sommer van my vroukie hier van die Wapen van Amsterdam af. Dit maak my, dit raak maar alleen hier, so vooral vir die jongmans aan die Kaap. Daar is die mense wat graag daar wil saamlees, hulle het sommer hierdie troue gou afgerammel. Hier is alles net skepe en goed wat gebeur het en ek al het goed rondgeskuif en hier is nog briefies van Robben Island. En ek dink dit is eindelijk, dit is hier waar hulle klaar dat there are many ewes which after lambing desert their lambs. This greatly retards the increase. It would therefore be advisable if it pleases your honor to send some hay to be used for only those ewes which have lambed. When it is noticed that they have deserted their young, the ewes will be brought home with their lambs and given the hay, there being nothing to eat at present. Heel onder. Truthfully, it is a pity for me to see the lambs dying in this way. One of the ewes we are sending to your honor broke a leg here in the kraal in trying to avoid capture. It fell and broke a leg. Nou, as kan julle sien, daar is natuurlijke omstandighede hoekom van die skape doodgaan, maar hulle sommer nou vir Jan Woutersen gesê, sorry man, stot. Maar nou is het fijn, nou dat hierdie, wat is Olwagen, wat is die ouse story? Hier onder Ryk Overhagen. En snaaks genoeg hier Ryk Overhagen, hy sê ook, please send me some paper as I have not a sheet left for writing to your honor. Hier kom nog skepe. Die Elbrug, with 150 men on board, all of whom were still alive, and only one of whom was ill. En dan nog een skip, die Meese, with 63 men on board. One man had deserted, 6 men had died on the voyage, and another was dying, while the majority were suffering from scurvy. Dat maak my uit redelijk siek. Hier aangekom. Die Meese. En daar het hulle, dis nou die selle paarkie, Griekie en, wat is die ander ouse, die man se naam, Hendrik, denk ek. Hendrik Hendriksen en Griekie Fransen. Daar word hulle nou actually getrouw, so hulle het gaan goed die trouwe afgerammel. Hier kom ons nou weer by die slawe. Arrangements were started for establishing a school for the company's male and female slaves brought here from Angola by the Amersfoort, which had taken them off a prize Portuguese slaver. The sick comforter Pieter van der Staal of Rotterdam has been entrusted with the task of giving them instruction in the morning and afternoon, besides his duties of visiting the sick. Particularly because he reads Dutch well and correctly. To encourage the slaves to attend and to hear or learn the Christian prayers, it is ordered that after school everyone is to receive a small glass of brandy and 2 inches of tobacco. All their names are to be written down, and those who have none are to be given names, paid or unpaid, young or old. All this is to be done in the presence of the commander, who will attend for a few days to put everything in proper order and subject these people to proper discipline, signs of which are already apparent. All the slaves are also being properly clothed to protect them against the daily increasing cold. The strongest have also been put to work so that they may as soon as possible be of service to the settlement. Nou, hier so staan, all their names are to be written down, and those who have none are to be given names. Ek wonder of hierdie lyste nog bestaan, en of mense by hierdie name kan uitkom. Strafreg, o jel, daar word martelings toegepas op die mense, glo dit of nie. The officers of the flute Meese communicated and produced to us certain confessions by the persons Gilles Huyglot of Lille and Jan Robertson of St. Nicholas, Philip Spoikie of Lille and Adrian Lefleur, all soldiers on board the above mentioned flute made under their signature to the effect that it was their intention on the night of 7 March to kill certain persons and to make themselves masters of the ship. Nou, hoekom sal iemand so 'n verklaring teken? Sou jy het geteken het? Hoor nou. Further proceedings could be taken against the captives or torture applied to them. Also that the above mentioned person, except Huygelot, had emphatically denied their confessions, declaring that they had made them through fear of torture such as had been inflicted on Huygelot by the ship's council by means of thumb screws. The pain of these was still fresh in his memory and the scar still visible on his left thumb, in order to make him confess that he had stolen something. So dit smaak want die ouens word gedreig met marteling, dan sê hulle sommer okay fine, ons het dit nou gedoen, al het hulle dit nie gedoen nie. Net om daai, jy weet, die marteling te ontglip. So lyk dit vir my. Dalk het hulle dit goed gesteel, ek weet ookie. Daar kan julle verder lees. Ek het myself boeglam geskrik toe ek die story hoor. Dis die Wille Weste, papie. Dis die Wille Weste, hier vat hulle niks nonsens mee. Laaste twee bladsye, ons kan nou gaan doodoes. Hulle sê heel onder, it was therefore decided to send the prisoners to Batavia in the Vloed Elbrug with the documents containing the charge against them. Jan sê, ek is nie lus vir hierdie saakie. Batavia toe met julle. Dat die groot baas besluit. Op die 25ste April 1658, today the Freeman's vessel Pagoin again left for the Robben Island and was commissioned to bring seal meat, salted and dried, for feeding the slaves, for which we promised to pay 2.5 gulden per 100 pounds. En hier kom nou nog een skipje in die Kaap in. Die Dordrecht, with 364 paid men on board, of whom 14 had died and 6 had deserted at the island of St. Vincent. Today the Freeman's vessel Pagoin returned with 3 half orms of train oil and 120 pounds seal meat to be used for a trial in feeding the slaves. Also a few thousand eggs, which the freemen themselves sell to the men from the ships at 4 for a double stiver. They are somewhat larger than goose eggs. The seal meat, which had been cooked, was fed to the slaves, who liked it very much. An agreement was accordingly made with the freemen to supply as much as possible at a fixed price. Nou maar fluit, my story is uit. Die eerste slawe het aangekom. Hulle is besig om 'n skool te bou. Hulle het klere vir die ouens gekry en hulle word rop vleis gevoer. Dit klink nie vir my baie aangenaam nie. Ek dink nie rop vleis is so lekker nie. Anders sou die burgers het myself ook geëet het. O, koek. Trek gou. Ek gaan nog 'n vinnige entry light en as die chat heeltemal dood is, gaan ek sê tata bye bye. Ek het nog eentje wat hier lê. So een halve rook voor ek nacht sê. Oh. Ek sien ons trek alweer onder die 10 kykers. Ek gaan weer propaganda moet saai. Nou maar mense, as dit nou dit is, gaan ek sommer net sê tot ziens. Ek gaan vir die slag weer 'n bietjie op die Discord uitdank. Die ouens wat by die Discord wil kom chill, ek gaan vanaand weer, ek gaan 'n musiekie opsit, maar ek wil sê die nonsens gesels oor enige iets wat julle op julle hart het. Die skakel is ter ouder gewoonte in die beskrywing. En ek wil vir julle sê baie dankie dat julle ingeskakel het. Onthou daar is absoluut geen skaamte daarin om jou kop uit jou gat te trek nie. Staan op vir daardie mense wat vir jou opstaan en is altyd volhard in. Hou koers.